be sure that the defendant is appropriately appraised of anything that might be exonerating him, at least consistent with the ethics of the profession, I'd like to hear from each of you how you will go about making sure that's going on in your office and that every assistant district attorney is performing that task.
Same order?
Yeah, that's fine. Same order.
Mr. Price, I appreciate the question. I can tell you how I will address that issue if I have the opportunity to serve as your elected district attorney. One of the things that I'm going to do is I'm going to have a conversation with all of the law enforcement chiefs here in Travis County, the Travis County Sheriff's Office, and all of the smaller jurisdictions. And I'm going to explain to them that from January 1st forward, I expect them to do full and thorough investigations of those felony cases before they submit them to our office, before they submit them to the district attorney's office. That's number one. And I can tell you from the past 8 years that I've worked in that, outside that office, when I've been in private practice and I've been representing people like Michael Kerr, I have unfortunately seen that all too often does not happen. Cases are filed with the district attorney's office that were never thoroughly investigated, and in many instances, people like Michael Kerr sit in our county jail for months on end. Mr. Kerr, it was about 11 and a half months before the evidence that ultimately exonerated him resulted in the dismissal of his case. That evidence existed January 29th of last year, the same day that Mr. Kerr was arrested, but it was never put in the prosecutor's file. It was never relayed to me as his attorney. The second thing that I will do is I will insist that the prosecutors that are assigned to the grand jury division thoroughly investigate those cases, thoroughly review them, I should say, before they present them to the grand jury, because I can tell you from 21 years of experience, both here in Austin 9 years and 12 in Dallas County, that grand juries essentially are going to rubber stamp whatever is put in front of them. The idea that there is a thorough grand jury investigation, that may take place in cases involving police shootings, but your run-of-the-mill case, they are presented with a summary of information that often lasts less than 5 minutes, and then they have to go and vote on it. The prosecutors that are assigned to that division need to thoroughly screen those cases, and unless they are convinced that they have a case that they can prove to a jury, they need to do one of two things. They either need to reject it out of hand, or they need to send it back to the law enforcement authority and tell them, look, you need to do further investigation.
I would agree with all of that, but specifically as to producing discovery to the defense attorney. There's a recent ethics opinion that came out right in the end of December that makes it very clear that the prosecutors have an ethical duty to produce any kind of relevant evidence that's broader than brand. And I think that it's critical that all of the attorneys what I did 9.5 years of civil litigation for the D's office.
Misunderstanding about two things that were asked about. The grand jury stuff I know wasn't actually asked about, but to suggest that grand juries just rubber the stamp here in Travis County, I see numerous grand jurors around the room. That's not how the grand jury system works. We do a lot of screening, and there's a lot of information that's provided to the grand jury. Grand jurors want more, they're given more, but talk to some of the people in this room who have served on the grand jury. But the discovery process is what the question was about, what we would do. The interesting thing about Travis County, the stuff that the Michael Morton Act has now instituted, we've been doing that for years. People used to say to us, why aren't you more like Williamson County and that we want you to be tougher on crime? Williamson County had a discovery process where they showed very little to the defense attorneys. Our discovery process in Travis County has always been what we call open file discovery. Whatever we know about the case, other than our personal case notes, we have always given that to the defense attorney. It's not a broken system here. We've always done it the right way. Now the Michael Morton Act requires that we make copies of stuff that we ordinarily would not have made copies of, like photographs and things like that. So nothing really has changed. It's just a matter of making sure everybody in the office understands the culture of that office. Thank you.
Sir, in the green shirt, raise your hand.
Yes, I got a question for all three, but specifically the district attorney. My name is Michael Kerr, and you were the district attorney over the, you know, whatever happened. With respect, I thought that the district attorney's office was about justice, not only for the innocent people, but for the guilty people as well. I understand you want to protect the community from dangerous people. You know, I have a criminal past, and I may have been dangerous at one point in my life, but then we changed as they got programmed and things of that nature. But my life was destroyed for something that I didn't do, and they had evidence from day one. So I want to know, once one of you guys get elected, whatever the case may be, because you just said something that was a completely conflict of what happened in my case. You said that there's an open record. You know, Travis County has had an open record situation. Well, I was locked up from day one, and I didn't get my discovery till the day of my jury, picking my jury. That was 11 and a half months later, so that's not the truth. At least, you know, from your position, you didn't see it. And I'm not trying to insult you. I'm quite sure you got a million accolades. And right here, I've been out of jail a week, and I have nothing. I lost my family. I lost my job. I was working in the oil field. I want to know, what are you going to do if you get elected office to make sure that this doesn't happen? Because I lost everything. And you just sat up here in my face and told these people a bold lie. And I don't mean to insult you, but that was a lie. And I got all the paperwork to prove it right here in my truck. The biggest thing that you could have did, I've been asking for discovery from the day that I got there. I never seen my discovery. And then once the defense attorney finally got the discovery, they dismissed my case. So I stayed locked up for a whole year. I don't get any, they don't give me the $75 that they had me for locked up, that they were getting for me a day. I get nothing. I got to start from scratch. I can't find a job. It's difficult. So what are you gonna do to fix the system that you have, because it's obviously broken? Maybe you might need to try Williamson County's way, because the way that you got right now is not the truth. It's a facade. None of these people are criminals or none of that.
I'm sorry to interrupt. I just want to get everyone a chance to respond to your very good question.
And look, I think it's clear to everybody that you are planning it by Rick Reed. He's been marching you out to every forum since we started this process about the one innocent client he has who the police didn't turn over information to. What you're talking about is not a district attorney issue. What Rick Reed has said repeatedly is the police had this information and they didn't turn it over until the last minute, and then the DA's office, I'm assuming he's talking about turning it over to him. So that's not a DA discovery issue that you talked about at all. The duty of the district attorney is to see that justice is done in every case. Sometimes justice means dismissing a case. Sometimes justice means going forward on a case and prosecuting the case. It just depends on the case. I understand he's brought you out here so you can give this story about what happened to you, and that's fine, but the criminal justice system is about more than one case that Rick Reed considers to be an injustice.
Something that Mr. Cobb said a few moments ago, that Mr. Kerr is a plant and was suggesting that he and I had collaborated in some way, and I had asked him to ask that question. Mr. Kerr, had I asked you to pose any questions this evening?
No,
Absolutely not. I can't even vote. I'm here because I've lost everything. So they say that the people are the voice. So I'm a person. I'm a citizen. I'm somebody. I came to specifically find out how I got locked up all of this time for nothing. Okay. Nobody, no district, and I specifically wrote the district attorney's office, and they had it. You know what they told? You know what they told my lawyer? Because he didn't ask me to come out here. They told my lawyer that they can't give him discovery right now. They're not going to give it to him. It wasn't the police. They had the discovery from the beginning. They weren't going to give it to him.
Right, let me clarify something. The document, the evidence that I referred to when I was initially addressing this issue, existed on January 29th, the same day that Mr. Kerr was arrested. That evidence was available to the district attorney's office. Now, whether or not they saw fit to request that the various agencies that were involved in this investigation produce that document at that time, obviously they didn't, because it wasn't provided to me until December 28th. But I'll tell you what I will do that I think will address this issue more than anything else. I will lobby the Texas legislature to change the law so that people like Mr. Kerr that are arrested and stuck in jail for a year at a time are compensated the same way as somebody who is sent to prison for a crime they didn't commit.